Hi guys, in this video we'll talk about the top 10 colleges through Maharashtra CET. I'm going to make a separate video as well for the top 50 for those who want to fill the cap round. For this video, we mainly focus on the top 10 colleges in Mumbai through CET. Yeah, so I've divided them into four brackets. So band D, and then we have band C, band B, and band A. So at band D, at the lowest in the top 10 is Chetna, Xavier's, MET, and IAS. So these four colleges are based in top 4. Chetna, MET, IAS are based in Bandra, and Xavier's is based in Churchgate. So to convert that call, you need a minimum of 97 percentile in the CET paper. That's what my thumb rule says. Now this year, with all these categories come into picture, the 66% seats are reserved for the category, so this number might change, but mota yes, cap round 4 aate counseling round ke end mein aate you might get admission at 97% time. But out of them, Chetna, MET, IAS have a PGDM course as well, which where you can easily convert at 80% time. So PGDM cutoff is 80% time and MS cutoff 97% time. So those who are going for the cap round now, so this is a side you have to look at. For those who plan to give next year, or those who want to look at the PGDM courses, I think now the dates are all over for this year, but for then next year this might help you as well. So top band D college, Chetna, Xavier's, MET, IAS. Then if you move to band C college, we have Pumba, SIS, Dalmia. So Pumba obviously beat the other people because the intake is less. Pumba intake is still very less as compared to other. SIS, Dalmia, now intake is touching 400 into their main program and the extra program they've started. So intake is almost 350 to 400. Because of 350-400 intake, the placement obviously will take more time to get placed, or you need to work really hard in the college to get the placement. So this is where Pumba come into picture. Pumba will obviously outshine the other B schools. So for getting into these colleges, cutoff is around 98.8% to 98.5%. Pumba obviously will be 99% plus this year as well. And SIS Dalmia have the PGDM as well. To convert their PGDM, 90% is good enough. Why the cutoff is high than MS? Not because MS have very good program compared to that. MS have no GDPI, it's a direct admission. So that's why there's no cutoff, there's no GDPI. So that's why high call. And SIS Dalmia, because of the PGDM, you're invited for the GDPI call and all, the cutoffs are really high. Moving to the so this is band C from my point of view. So average salary of Chetna, MET, IAS, you can check on their website as well, will be around 5 to 6 lakhs. Yeah, that's going to be a range if you're getting admission to these colleges. SIS, Dalmia, Pumba. Now, Dalmia, SIS average salary is touching around 7.5 lakhs. Yeah, this is salary this year. And by the time you will be joining and passing out, obviously this number will increase. Now, moving to the band B, we have a Sydenham College, KJ Somaya, Wellinker. And trust me, all these three colleges are equal in terms of their placements. Equal means equal. The only problem is Sydenham intake is 180 and KJ Somaya intake is 480, Wellinker intake is 600. Because the intake is high, Somaya, Wellinker rank will remain below Sydenham. See, Sydenham is obviously a better choice because of ROI, fees is very less, and number two, the intake is very less. Because of these two reasons, obviously Sydenham will remain number two. Cutoff wise, Wellinker this year will be around 99.4. I'm talking about the last cutoffs, yeah, last round cutoffs. For example, Wellinker first round will end at 99.5. Then second round 99.4. Third round might go to 99.3 as well. But that's a mota cutoff. Somaya cutoff will be around 99.6. Sydenham cutoff 99.75 approximately. Yeah, Somaya have a PGDM as well. For PGDM, they accept CAT score, cutoff 85% and CMAT score, cutoff 97% for the PGDM. Same way, Wellinker cutoff is around 80% for all the courses. They have obviously they have more seats, so more courses. Now look at that, where Somaya CET cutoff 99.6, Somaya CAT cutoff 85%. So for them, CET 99.6 is same as CAT 85. Then Sydenham 99.75, there is no PGDM, there is PGDM but that is through the CET round only. And number one obviously is JBIMS, Jamnal Bajaj, cutoff this year will be 99.94, but I am claiming 95 because of reservation issue. 95 plus वाले को मिलेगा, 95 वाले का भी डाइसी है, 96 पे पक्का जे भी मिलेगा, 95 वाले को जे भी मिल सकता है, ठीक है. फॉर दैट वी नीड टू वेट फॉर द सीट मैट्रिक्स टू कम टू नो एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आर द नंबर ऑफ सीट इन दैट कॉलेज. जे भी हैव नो पीजीडीएम प्रोग्राम, सो दिस इज अ कट ऑफ. एवरेज सैलरी सिडनम डाल सिडनम सुमाया विलिंकर इज नाउ 8 to 9 lakhs. There are people who are getting 10 plus as well, but I'm talking about the average is around 8, 9, 10 तक जाएगा वो. JB this year average is touching 20 lakhs. This is a difference between band A and band B, that there is a huge gap, salary becomes सीधा double. So if you get 4 marks less in the CET paper, you are going to Sydenham, 4 marks ज़्यादा is JB. So you can see the huge difference between them. ठीक है, so these are the top 10 colleges through CET. Yep, I'll be making more videos like this for top 50 colleges as well, to help you in the caprounds and all. So do subscribe to the channel if you have not yet done that, so that you can get all the updates for the cutoffs. So because now the capround is going to start after 1 week, so all these videos will help you in the capround as well to fill accordingly. Yeah, because this year they are saying that you can fill up to 300 colleges in capround. So 300 may obviously not going to fill all 300, but top 50, top 60, whichever you want to put, I'll help you for that. So do subscribe to the channel. Alright, so I think this video will help you to understand what are the top 10 colleges in CET. Alright. All the best.